Hola, amigos. Yo soy Kevin.
Today we're going to work on this nice Epson Workforce WF7720. The printer starts, okay. The printer going to scan the right side of the printer, and then suddenly it's going to move to the left and stuck there. And you're going to get a ding, 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 and 00000031. And if you don't know what this error code is, just Google Epson error code BCH, and you're going to see this Epson's triple secret error code. Or you can just text EP error to this number. I'm going to send the link over. It has all the secret code. Just do a search. You'll probably want to bookmark this page for future reference. I will also include a link to the page on the description of this video. So 31 means the CR, which is the printhead carriage. Load position excess load error. So either the page feed motor failed, or page feed drive mechanism overload. The paper jam, foreign object. We don't have any foreign object. And we saw the motor was rotating, so not those two. Oh, tooth skip of the PF timing belt. That could be. So we need to check the timing belt. Oh, improper tension of the PF timing belt. Yeah, that could be it. Or cable disconnection. That could be it. The printer doesn't know where the printhead is. So it reads little marks on this clear timing belt to tell where the printhead is. At the beginning of the startup, the printhead move all the way to the right. It move until it cannot move anymore. So that's considered position zero. And then it move to the left certain marks, let's say 80 marks or 120 marks. And that's the maximum left position. So if you have a dirty belt and it skip a couple marks, I love the sound. Anyway, so it skip a couple marks. So now when it says, okay, I'm going to move 120 ticks, your printer will not be long enough to do that now. So it slam all the way to the left. So that could be it. So let me finish cleaning up this. When you're cleaning, just use regular water, warm water, or alcohol. See this part? It needs to be cleaned. And all the dried ink up here. See, I'm using 50% water and 50% of alcohol. Put a piece of wet paper behind it, and then now I can see some stubborn ones. For the stubborn ones, I use the BCH cleaning solutions. We have three levels. We have clear cleaning solution, green cleaning solution, and the red cleaning solution. This one, I'm using the red one because it's really stubborn. I'll put up the link just in case the water and the alcohol will not do much for you. That look clean. Okay, let's give a spin. The other two things it's talking about is either the clear belt skip the reader, and if you take the cover off, and you can see if the clear belt is go through the reader, which it is for this in this case, and also, and the belt tension is okay. You can see it's totally flat, and also check the spring that's holding the belt is good. I'm going to put another link to show you how to install the spring if your spring falls off. Okay, let's see if it works. Now it's reading the right, and it looks good. So over air is actually reoccurring. So we'll try a couple times. So it'll be either 00031 or 00023. If we see the error code 23, it's almost the same thing. It's still the carriage. It cannot reverse. It's a reverse error. So when you go to left, the encoder failure, or you have like a tooth skip. So everything is telling you is the printer has a problem go the full length of the printer. So that's why it slammed into the left. So you have to think, what's the causes to make the printer not wide enough? Upon further troubleshooting, we found the problem is, say, the printer cannot go all the way to the right. There's something stops it. So therefore, if the printer think that's zero and start moving to the left, the printer going to run out of spaces, so slam to the left, because they thought it has still have a way to go. And the reason it cannot go all the way to the right is this little piece is sticking up. The position is too high. That's exactly the piece that's going to generate a 0x69 code. I have another video showing how to play with it. If you can fix it. If you can't get it fixed, that piece is still sticking up for too high. You can go get another one from bchtechnologies.com. Just search for waste assembly, and looking for WF3640. We rarely have WF7720 or 7710 or 7610, those web format ones. So what you can do is you can buy the exactly same one for the regular format, the regular length one. The only difference is those 3640, this last piece, the last tube is shorter than 7720 because your printer is longer. But you already have this tube in your printer, so you can just swap the tube. I'll show you how to do it. Just like take a second. And we have brand new ones that's never been touched. They're virgin, okay? And also we have a dirty slot, more like slotty ones. Today I'm gonna use a slotty one, so as example, show you. They're in pretty good shape. The only thing is there may be a couple drop of ink on it, and you can tell it's used. But however, I guarantee you it's in really good shape. I'll put off another video show you how to take the case off. I guess somebody complaining from Hawaii said my video is too long, so I'm going to cut it short. I'm going to the warehouse, grab some used waste assembly, and just show you the used is in pretty good shape. So it's up to you. Some people like never used, and somebody like more experienced waste assembly. The only drawback is some of them may still have waste ink in it. So the wrapper, this is brand new one. So see, this like everything is super, super clean. And if you get some ink coming out, it's going to be just like this one, just a little bit of smudge on the cover. But if you see all the plastic side is all clear. You won't get beat up ones even you buy used. So next step is I'm going to show you how to put this waste assembly inside there. And remember that this tube will not be long enough. You will need to use the tube that's inside the printer. We need to remove two screws. One screw is on the top right. And you need a number two Phillips screwdriver. For the other screw, you have to slide the thing to the right. Again, screw number one and screw number two. And be careful, the waste assembly doesn't include this part, this lever and the spring underneath. If you lose it, you have to buy them separately. I'll put a link to this little spring and the white lever on the top of this video, so in case you lost them. You'll collect them as soon as I remove the two screws. Gently slide the assembly to the right a little bit. You can see the spring underneath. I already used a piece of magnet to remove the spring and the white lever. Don't worry, even if they fall down, if you do everything nicely, they just lay on the bottom for you to pick them up. On the side, remove those three screws. And look at the one that's straight down there. Easier at this angle. Remember, don't remove the screw with the Y piece. And in the front side, just remove all the visible screws. And there's one horizontal plate that you can take out. And then the whole thing comes loose. Do not remove the side plate. Just lift it up a little bit. And you can gently slide the wisdom assembly out. This is the reason that we remove that little white lever and the little spring before doing this, because when you jiggle it, you might lose it. So we're going to salvage this long tube and put it on a new whisk assembly. And now get yourself a piece of rubber band. Pick out the white lever and put the hoop of the little spring on it. And then kind of fishing, try to attach to the another black hook on the assembly. Now use your rubber band to secure it. And this is how it should look. Now we can start putting back. I won't bother you too much about every screw, but however, when you insert this, make sure you target that hole right there. And for the Y lever, to be able to move the lever, the force is transferred from that gear to the lever. So just make sure that you have a good contact with that gear. Put the top screw first, then do the lower one. Now you can get a pair of scissors and cut and remove the rubber band. Okay, now let's check the Y lever. If we rotate this disc counterclockwise, the Y lever should stay down. But if we rotate it clockwise, the Y lever should go up. And also check the printed carriage. Now you can see the carriage can go all the way to the right. Okay, after we put back all the screws, we can give a test. The printhead is going to spend some time on the right to figure out what zero position is, and then it's going to move all the way to the left. Here is where we had a problem before. Okay, I hope you enjoyed this video. Visit us at www.bchtechnology.com or locally at Greensboro, North Carolina. Cheers!